Today you are going to discover three ways to create a Gantt chart in PowerPoint. We'll teach you how to set it up manually and show some publicly available templates. By the end, you'll also learn how to make a powerful Gantt chart even easier with a professional tool. To start with, add a new slide. Next, go to the Insert tab, expand the table icon, and select 10 cells. You'll also need to change their height and width to fit the canvas. The first three columns will be occupied with task titles. That is why we'll need to add 5 more to account for month names. To create the task name section, select the first three columns and click Merge in the top pane. Now that we have the table, let's work with the visual appeal. Here, you may select all the columns and go to Border Properties. Select all borders and adjust their weight. You can also pick some other color for the outline and remove the fill of the table. Now let's go back to the technical aspects of the chart. Here, we have to split the first column into multiple rows. For that, select the first column and click Split. Set the number of columns to 1 and adjust the number of rows to the amount of your tasks. Then, go ahead and enter your tasks. You can change the text color, alignment, and other attributes according to your preferences. To add month names, we'll need to insert text boxes above the columns. Let the first one be January. Then, just duplicate the box with Ctrl plus D, place the copies above the remaining columns, and update the abbreviations accordingly. This might seem time-consuming, but don't worry. The third method on our agenda will enable you to skip all this cumbersome preparation and start creating a Gantt chart right from the beginning. Finally, we are ready to proceed to the timeline. Go to the Insert tab again. In the Shapes drop-down menu, choose Rounded Rectangle and place it alongside the task name. These bars will represent the start and end dates and duration of the tasks. Besides, you can take the same steps to show dependencies between the tasks. Choose the connector you like, draw links where needed, and change the style of the arrows. It might become easier to distinguish the tasks if you paint the bars with different colors. For your convenience, you can also format the month's columns. Just right-click the column and choose 7% black in the cell shading options. Let's suppose you're in March and want to reflect this progress on your Gantt chart. With the help of rectangles, you can assemble a simple marker and group the elements. To do it, hold Shift, select both the line and the label, and press Ctrl plus G. As a result, you will be able to slide the marker depending on the progress you've made so far. That is it! Your PowerPoint Gantt chart is ready! For those who don't want to create their own Gantt chart, there are plenty of free templates publicly available on the internet. You can find 10 examples in our blog by the link in the description. It may be the case that, despite making your presentation in PowerPoint, you'd like to insert a more professional and complex Gantt chart. That is when GanttPRO, an online project management software, might lend you a hand. Once you log in on GanttPRO.com, you'll need to take a few steps. Firstly, set up your project. Introduce the title and the start date. Customize working days and hours, and press Create a new project. Click Add a task, and it will automatically appear on the right side of the screen. You can move it around to reposition the task on the timeline. Change the start and end dates manually, or by using our simple drag and drop feature. The duration will be calculated automatically. Organize work breakdown structure by dividing all long stages of your project into smaller tasks and subtasks. Set dependencies that, unlike those in PowerPoint, indeed make your plan more flexible and responsive to changes. In this software, you can also include additional task details in fields next to each title. Display estimation, priority, budget, labels, and many more. GanttPRO allows for easy collaboration with your team members and enables to keep track of the resources they need. Just invite your team, assign tasks, and calculate costs by setting rates and units. The app is not only useful in the project planning phase, its users, can also track all actual progress and changes throughout the whole execution. If one needs to share the current achievements with stakeholders, there's a fully customizable shared private link available. But let's imagine you want to export your timeline. Select Export and adjust the settings. Firstly, you can choose one of the four available formats. Let's go for PNG. Secondly, specify the project's details that should be included in the chart. And finally, export your project. You can now share the document or present your project plan to the audience. You might also want to add it to your PowerPoint presentation. In this case, just insert the exported Gantt chart as a picture. These were the three ways to create a Gantt chart, different yet effective in their own way. After studying them, you should now have a clear idea of which one suits your needs, whether to stick with PowerPoint or try out such powerful project management tool as GanttPRO.